That's
my song.
That Mocha that you were talking about, that's the Mocha King. See, it's so much I'm trying to catch myself up on, because I read between the lines and everything he mostly said.
Yep.
Yeah. I caught everything. Like,
yep.
That mark on your body, what he said, that mark on your body, before I even speak on it, which you should all know, I caught it, but if you got a mark on your body that's containing the devil into you, what mark is that?
What the
mark? I'm asking, it's a question. I mean, really, it's not rhetorical. I'm really asking the question. That mark that he spoke on, if it's a mark of the beast, and who is the beast? The fucking Mark of King. Like, can't kill it, but it was
his mark.
Right. So like I said, I caught it, and there's so much shit that I want to question him on what he said, just to make sure that I was right.
Mm-hmm.
I know I'm right, because I know I'm right.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't, it's so much that I'm...
You appreciate lyrics, that's good.
Yeah.
Do you appreciate art?
Right. I appreciate art.
DJ Harbra.
Like,
DJ Harbra.
A lot of
DJ
people sitting here, like, the artists that blew up right now, they blew up because they dick riding. In fact, they whatever the fuck your man to tell you to do, you're doing it while you're exposing the
uh-huh.
Me, on the other hand, I'm like I tell you, and I, let me tell you, I had to stop myself. Because this is their exposure, not mine. I wanted to present a song to y'all. Because I know what type of love you're going on because I do my homework. And I know how rap come and rap means you cannot talk. So it's no full gauge on what I'm saying. I couldn't do what I want to do. I want to present itself. But a lot of artists, they are doing what the fuck the hype is.
Yeah.
What about real hip hop? What about real music? Can you really be an artist and with, like, perfecting your craft? You gotta talk about shooting a nigga up in every song you make.
What's the meaning behind what you want to say? What are you trying to say anyway? Do you know?
How many real artists can actually make a song that somebody will appreciate? Yeah.
There you go.
No, you asked me, I told you.
Yeah.
Now you asking me, can I back up what I'm saying?
I'd like to see that.
But like I told Gunner, this is not my spotlight. This is an ice situation. I knew what he was going to do, and he defended himself with a song.
Now, if my agent can speak, I
want
to know. Give me a card.
Hey, can I? That's what I was going to do.
Wait, what?
I present myself as a fact is, the reason why I feel like I had to, like, commentate on Child 70, because I'm the one who asked to perform. That's why. The fact is, I gotta back up on what I wanted to see.
Right.
So how can I ask you to do something that I can't do, right?
Can.
I just told you. I just told Big Ram. I looked up to
you. I can show. Can you show?
Can I what? Why would I ask Ike to do something that I can't do for myself? I mean, ask you to perform.
Right.
But how can I get you to entertain somebody and I can't do it?
Right.
How can I criticize you if you didn't do a good performance? If I can't do it, who am I to say anything? But at the end of the day, I love what everything I got going on. Man, I didn't do them for my birthday. We was in Texas together. I got my line. Right. So like I say, I salute everything he got going on. And his lyrics, the way his song was, the message I got out of it, a lot of people wouldn't get it. And they wouldn't like it because they don't understand. The shit that he was saying, metaphors, I caught everything. And like I say, it's so many questions that I want to ask to make sure that I was right. I got my Bible, but I don't even know how to ask them. But if I hear a song, you play a song again, I'd be like, call you.
Right.
Did you play that? Did you play that?
That's right.
I'm that type of person.
Like, break this down. All right, bar for bar. What
the thing is, like I said, I'm an A&R as well. And I know what he meant, but the thing was that it was so fucking powerful.
What did you mean by it though? Like, what did he mean by it? Sometimes we write stuff and it has a general meaning, right? But then there's even a deeper meaning because as a writer, you have something deeper in your subconscious you're trying to get out. You feel me? So, like,
right.
It's like, I could ask you, what does it mean when you said the sky was blue and the leaves were purple?
Right.
What does that mean? It could mean something in my head, but you could have some totally different perception of, like, what that meant.
Right.
Let me dissect what you just said and the best perspective I got out that so far than me growing up from a child band right now. It's when Wayne first said, I'm probably in the sky, flying with the fishes, or maybe in the ocean, swimming with the pigeons. See, my world is different, like the Wayne Wade. I didn't need, like, a T. I understood the first metaphor, but Dwayne was the nigga that was on a different world with the glasses. Mm-hmm. His world was different, so like I said. But then, like, I mean, I analyze shit different, and everything he said, his metaphors, it stuck with me to when he hit me with the next one, and it was like questioning the fuck he mean by that. And when it got to me, like it's a Zuko puzzle, and when it got to me, I knew the answer, right? I love artists like that. I don't want people to say and give me, oh, the fucking napkin is white like cocaine. Nigga, I fucking knew that already. Tell me what you think, like that. Give me some shit that's gonna make me really think. Like, a lot of people never read the Bible. I wanna know what the fuck, like, Michael, like, I wanna know what the fuck him and Lucifer had their beef about. Like, I wanna know why the fuck did Lucifer get struck down to hell. When you put a metaphor in that in your song, and it got me thinking, nigga, you know what? You got me. I sold my soul to you. You know what? I'm your fan. Right. That's how the fuck I feel. Can't too many artists do that because everybody want to talk about shooting a nigga.
Same thing, over and over again. Whatever brings money, people want to do. Right. You know what I'm saying? And that's not even the way.
And it's not like open your mind to anything. Like, they
want to
keep you closed.
Right. Yeah. And the fact is, I hate to say this,
thinking about stuff.
Me having this conversation, I look at her earrings, I'm going to tell you how much of an artist I am. When I sit here and say that, and I look at her earrings, when they talk about that gang shit, you want to be a different artist. You want to be different. You want to find out what's different from you and NBA Youngboy. Her earrings. They bring you down. But the fact is, all you want to do is talk about shooting my bang bang, just like NBA Youngboy. Find something different to make you different. J. Cole found his own route.
Yeah.
Why the fuck everybody else can't find their own route?
Right.
You feel me? That's why I feel like I am different. I am Lucky D Bipolar. I have two different personalities in my artist, like my music. Lucky D Bipolar, he talks about the emotional, self-centered shit, like you having feelings for a female. Bipolar D, he talked about that street shit, but I'm not gonna actually tell you that I shot a nigga. The fact is, you wanna tell you why? I'm gonna put it metaphorically. You gotta read between the lines on exactly what the fuck I mean. So if you can't catch the fact that I can't remember this fucking line I put, but it's the Lion King. The fact is, I'm fucking Mufasa and you Scar. And the fact is, you want to see me win, but deep down in your soul, you really don't.
Right.
And like I said, I move faster, you skull. You don't want to see me win. And I can't remember exactly what I said, but it's a metaphor. And the fact that I have no problem backing myself up. Hey, I would drop a song right here and perform. And that's what I wanted. I used to do on that song that when I was feeling his lyrics so much in that song. But it just so happened he wanted the acapella.
Right.
And that's what he did.
Right.
But I am the type to where I give a good performance. I tell everybody who buy a ticket for me for each show, which is Gully Balls, me and him, we do have the pandemonium that's going on. So I am I'm a person to where I tell you, if you buy a ticket for me, and if I don't entertain you, I put it on everything I love. I will refund everybody who bought a ticket from me. I will refund you your fucking money before you walk out the building. And that's guaranteed.
Yeah.
So, like I said, I sell my shoes. The fact is, I will do whatever the fuck I gotta do, because the fact is, I guarantee I make you laugh. You can be a fucking street nigga. I guarantee I make you smile.
Yeah.
I guarantee I make you laugh. You're looking at me, I'm looking at you, bro. I just wanna see if you're gonna dare me right now. Because I'm gonna ask who to do it. I've been drinking, I'm on my level right now. I still can do it. So I'm trying to keep it professional because I see the cameras out, but I'm still waiting on Ike, because the fact is, I see him, got him to do that.
I think he wants to get Ice. It's gonna be a minute.
I got him the acapella, and I thought he was gonna perform what the song was playing. And I want to do this right now in front of our logo.
Do it a cappella.
I think it's better with the music playing.
Okay.
I can actually play it and I will do it. Like this, I know how to work it, but yeah, I want to do this on camera.
Yeah, don't touch it,
okay. I know, I mean, I host shows, I can show y'all videos, I host all Young Pro events. I know exactly what
I'm doing. No, I believe that, but that's his.
I know. And. Respect for him. You don't owe me no explanation. Okay. You say don't touch it,
I mean,
and you know what?
But it would be the same with y'all. You know?
I'm just like a child. Mama, you told me I can have ice cream.
What's your Spotify? You got music on Spotify?
I have music on, yeah, platforms, yes, everything.
Here, look.
The song that I actually want to do.
But how do I follow you?
Look at D Bipolar.
I'm
Insta
Bipolar.
It's on Spotify. You
hear me? I still touched it. He still touched it.
Big brother.
Big brother.
You really
I'm
big
telling.
Brother. Say, I swear to God, you big brother. I thought it'd be slick. You big brother.
He still touched it. He still touched it.
I'm telling.
And if you finish, you set it down,
because
I
got to
use it.
Check it out. I'm going to do this song off my phone, and I'm still going to perform in front of y'all.
Okay, well, we got
to... I just hate the fact that I asked him to do that and I couldn't...
I don't want... Yeah. I don't want to be like the... The lunch lady.
Oh, you good. You good. So, can you at least control the cafeteria right now?
I
can't
with the cats, but everybody
went to class. You still recording. You fed as fuck.
I'm waiting for everybody to come back. I don't want to hear it.
I'm about to make me a drink. I'm ready. Hold up.
It's
my dog about to go up.
You gonna lose the ceiling?
Hell no.
Okay, so wait till
I'm
everybody
entertained.
Comes
that's
back.
That's what I do. Wait till everybody comes back. The reason why I'm presenting this very soon right here, because I promise you, I can do street shit.